Brad Ziegler, who played in the major leagues, friend of the show, tweeted out something about how we use this netting in Japan, and I don't think the fans are bothered by it. You still get a chance to catch foul balls, and it's not like it's an invasion of your viewing habits here. And Brad, kind enough to join us on short notice. Why are we archaic? Why aren't we getting around to this, Brad?
I honestly don't know. I mean, the technology in netting, even just in the last 5 to 10 years, has come a long way. I mean, Atlanta was one of the first stadiums that I saw that put it up down to the end of the dugout. And when you were looking at the fans from the field, you can't even see the netting. And so it's so thin, but it's protective. And, you know, I said it in my tweet, like MLB is encouraging cell phone use at the ballpark with their MLB ballpark app. And if they're going to do that, they're basically saying, we're okay with you being distracted as long as you use our app. They have to protect the fans. This cannot happen. And this shouldn't even be a discussion just because people got hurt. That's it. This should have been a proactive discussion. Like I said, they do this in Japan, foul pole to foul pole. The games in Japan, people have a blast. Like the fans are having a great time there. The game is extremely popular. Like, this is not detracting from the game at all. And if anything, it enhances it because you can have more fun at the game instead of having to be locked in on the batter every single pitch.
But Brad, I don't understand what is the holdup for baseball? If the netting is, you know, it doesn't feel like it invades, you know, your viewing pattern here. I know you want to be close to the field, but you can still get foul balls there. Is it that much of a deterrent? Or, hey, I'm spending all this money, I don't want a netting in front of me?
That was the biggest complaint whenever, you know, and I had direct conversations with Rob Manfred about this. That was the biggest complaint, is that the people paying the most money at the game to you know, for their tickets down low are the ones that are going to be hindered by this, and they don't want it. They've been season ticket holders for a long time. They don't want to deal with it. Mm. Their thought was, let these fans who, you know, if you bring kids to the game or if you're older, you're not paying attention, whatever the scenario is, sit further away. And essentially it was very selfish, in my opinion, a very selfish opinion. And I just said, it doesn't matter if you do this. They want access to the players. They want to be able to get autographs. They want to be able to get the ball flipped into the crowd after each inning. And, you know, last year they extended them down to the end of the dugouts, and I didn't hear a single person complaining about their experience at the ballpark when they were sitting behind the dugout. So it just makes no sense. I guess that's their holdup is, you know, some fan complaints. But to me, like, this isn't even a question. You just have to do it.
What did the commissioner say when you told him your opinion?
He understood, and I told him, I said, Rob, what's it going to take? Is it going to take someone dying at a baseball game for this to happen? And that was, you know, that was even prior to them extending down past the end of the dugout. At that time, they basically, most of the parks stopped with the netting at the on-deck circle. And I said, it's dangerous. Like, if I was sitting in the crowd, someone who was playing the game, was in my prime, and I was sitting there with a glove, yeah, I don't know that I could catch a foul ball coming at me if I was right over the top of the dugout, because it's, when that ball's coming right at you at that angle, it looks like it's not moving toward you. It gets on you faster than it actually, you know, seems like it's going to. You just can't react to it. And I think they had done some kind of a survey of fans, and it was, they were trying to do what the fans wanted. And the problem is, the fans that were, you know, these longtime season ticket holders, they didn't want to lose them. And there were people saying that they would stop buying their tickets. And my thought is, you know what, like, I'm sorry if your viewing experience is more important than the safety of everybody in the park. That's an extremely selfish opinion. You can stay home and watch the game on TV, and let someone else will gladly take your seat.
Because I don't know what it says on your ticket, but I know as the commissioner of baseball, you don't want somebody to go to a game and leave on a stretcher. If you can prevent something like that, then you just do it. The commissioner should say, this is what I think is best. You sometimes have to protect people from themselves. And I don't,
absolutely.
You know, you had somebody die at a Dodger game. You know, they got hit at a game last August and died. And they said the injuries were from that foul ball. Like, we've had people die, and you had a 4-year-old who was hurt last night. I don't know what else it's going to take for somebody to say, you know what, that's it. We're going to do it.
Yeah, and in hockey, you know, there was a 13-year-old girl that died hit by a puck up behind the goal, and they immediately put netting up in every single hockey arena. And, yeah, some of the fans there complained because they weren't able to get the pucks that shot up there anymore. But you know what? In reality, it's better for everybody. And if you miss that one opportunity for your foul ball, like, I'm sorry, but you know what? It protects people every single night. I completely agree. I just think it's stupid that it hasn't happened yet, and I don't know what they're waiting for.
And also, you know that sound. Every ball player knows that sound. When that foul ball goes off the bat and it hits somebody, you know exactly where that person's been hit.
Yeah, and you could see by the players reacting last night, like, they were guys that, you know, aside from Almora, that were extremely emotional. You know, it makes you almost sick to your stomach thinking, like, did that just happen? Yeah. I was in Texas when playing against the Rangers when the man trying to catch the ball that Josh Hamilton was throwing into the crowd fell over the outfield wall and ended up dying. And it's just a sickening feeling to think that, like, someone came to the park to enjoy a night out with their family, to have fun at a game, and they died. Like, that just can't happen. It cannot happen. You can't wait until that happens to react to it.
Brad, great to catch up with you. We appreciate you being a fan of the show, and thanks for joining us.
Yeah, my pleasure. Thanks for having me on.
It's Brad Ziegler. He pitched in the bigs for 11 seasons. Got a tweet from him earlier today saying, they do this in Japan. They love their baseball there, and it's not this invasion that people think it is. But I understand where you have season tickets, you're down low, you're so close to the action, may get a foul ball, get to say something to the players. I understand all of that. But the commissioner's got to protect people from themselves.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV. Stream for free on BR Live or download the Dan Patrick Show app.